All right, Air Force Amy is suing Bunny Love, her co-worker, for damaged property. Hello, ladies.
Hi.
How are we today?
I'm great, thank you.
Good. All right, Air Force Amy, why are you suing Bunny Love?
Well, first let me tell you a little bit about my background. You may know my character, Air Force Amy, on the HBO series Cat House, and I'm really fun-loving, and I have a lot of fun, and I'm full of laughter, and I have this bit of laughter every time I orgasm. And, you know, I want you to know that I'm a very upstanding citizen. I don't lie, cheat, or steal. I just do a really good job. I'm a highly decorated veteran of the United States Air Force. I have an honorable discharge and a meritorious service medal, and I've worked as an anti-terrorism specialist and an airbase ground defense instructor. I have the highest academic award achievable, John Levitow Award, in the military. So I have these certain standards that I do apply within my job that I do now for the last 19 years working in the Nevada legal brothel industry. And Bunny Love is one of my best friends, and I've taken her under my wing, and she got to learn some things. I'll let her have borrow my room. We have these really nice rooms, these suites at the Bunny Ranch.
Back up. Take a breath. Now, how does one go from the Air Force to the Bunny Ranch?
Well, it's only like an hour away.
That was very good. Okay, how did you end up going into the Air Force? That's unusual.
Kind of by my ultimatums. I had an ultimatum that I said to this man, I said, fine, well, I'll join the Marines or the military, and that's what I ended up doing.
You mean you told him you either marry me or I join the military?
Well, no, he said that I drank too much and I need to go home and live with my grandma.
Where was home?
Tell me.
Where was home?
Ohio. But okay. I told him, I said, fine, I'll go join the Marines. And the Marines didn't take me, but the Air Force did.
Okay. So you were a ground base instructor?
Air base ground defense instructor. I took 44 men out in the field for 2 weeks at a time and taught them how to defend a runway.
Okay. All right. Now,
taught them how to stay alive.
Yeah.
Stay on top of it.
And stay on top of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The situation.
Yeah. Okay. Let me ask you this, Air Force Amy. When you left the military, really, how did you get to the Bunny Ranch?
Well, because
you're beautiful and you're smart and you've got a sense of humor.
Well, because of all the jobs that I was qualified for, I would have to have carried a gun for a living. And I didn't want to carry a gun for a living anymore. I got stationed at Las Vegas in Nevada, and I liked the bright lights and the pretty clothes and the glamour and the bling, and that lifestyle appealed to me more than carrying a gun for a living.
Okay. All right.
And
that
I wanted to make
sense.
A lot of money fast.
And do you?
I make a lot of money, yeah. Not fast all the time.
Okay. So, how long have you been at the Bunny Ranch?
8 years now, and I've been their top earner for every year that I work.
Why do you think you're the top earner? Why do men pick you? Do you stand in a line, actually?
Yeah, I don't get picked out of lineup very much. Look at what I compete against. You know, Bunny, they pick her way more than they pick me. But I do repeat business.
I guess it depends on what you like.
You know, well, if you like young and pretty and beautiful.
Every guy's different. It's Baskin and Robbins, 31 flavors. So.
But I have a great work ethic. I don't lie, I don't cheat, I don't steal. 90% of my business is repeat clients because I give good parties. I make the most money because I do the most for the money, and I have the most repeat clients.
Okay.
I don't have the most appointments, and I'm the best sex you will ever have, period, hands down. That's fact. I'm not the youngest, the prettiest, the maybe not even the nicest, not the thinnest or the youngest, but it is the best sex you will ever have, period.
I'm going to leave it at that. Now, over to you. Why is Air Force Amy suing you?
Well, first let me start and tell you a little bit about myself. My name is Bunny Love, and I've been at the Bunny Ranch now for 3+ years.
You get to the Bunny Ranch?
Well, I was a escort in Las Vegas. I was arrested and needed to stay out of trouble, and so that's right.
How are you arrested in Las Vegas? It's legal to be a prostitute.
No, it's not. That's common.
But it's legal at the Bunny Ranch.
Outside counties with cities of more than 250,000 population. So that excludes Las Vegas, and that excludes Reno-Carson County. So
prostitution is not legalized in Reno or Las Vegas. That's a big misconception. There's only two counties in the state that prostitution is not legalized in, and that's the counties that are holding. So you have to go to Bunny Ranch in Carson City, Nevada.
Yeah.
Carson City,
Nevada. You can find directions
Nevada.
At Bunny
You want to tell them what airport you landed?
Reno, Tahoe.
So when you were arrested, were you convicted?
Yes, I was convicted of one charge.
Any time?
No time. It was my first offense. So.
When you were on the streets, did you have trouble?
Yeah, I'd been assaulted before, and
but you still kept doing it.
Yeah, it's great.
Why?
It's great money. And I mean, I was never raped or anything. I know a lot of girls that have had worse things happen.
Let me tell you. I look at the plaintiff here. Mm-hmm. She is a tough woman. She gets it. I mean, no, she was in the Air Force. She gets it. I'm complimenting you.
Thank you.
You are not quite as seasoned as she is, and I'm not talking about age. So why is it that you went into this line of work? Weren't you afraid?
You know, not so much. I had started dancing, and then people say that if you'll strip, that then you'll be a prostitute. And so I kind of just went from there. I talked to other girls that had done it, and from there I went to Vegas. I'm from Oregon, so I went to Vegas and worked. And
but where she's at now is very safe.
Oh, that I know. That I know. I'm asking her about when she was on the street.
Yeah.
You know.
No, it wasn't wise at all. They weren't wise decisions. But
how old are you?
I'm 23.
23.
Yeah.
So. And you like what you do?
I have a great time.
I'm sure you have a great time. I must, you know.
You party like rock stars.
Yeah, you party like rock stars. I get it. You've got enough bling to blind anybody. But here's my question. Do you want to get married? Do you want to have kids?
You know, my take on kids is I figure that they're kind of overpopulated like cats. I will adopt one day. I'll take somebody else's, but
that makes you a cat yourself.
I don't
you know
feel that.
That
I...
I might adopt her.
Yeah.
I don't feel that I need to
You don't
to
want
reproduce.
To. Do you think you'll ever fall in love?
Oh, sure. I fall in love all the time, but...
A couple times.
Now, why are you suing her?
Well, Bunny asked me to use my room. We all have suites that we can keep and decorate any way that we want. And I put a lot of time and effort and money into my suite at the Bunny Ranch. Mm-hmm. And I was out of town once, and she wanted to borrow my room and use it for a party. And of course, I'm not no problem with that. I trust Bunny. But and she said it was for a big party. I didn't realize it was for a big guy. The guy was like 400 pounds, and they broke a lot of my stuff.
What did they break?
Well, they got a carpet stain, and they got wine all over the place.
What do you want to show me there?
I'm going to show you one of my blankets. This is...
Oh, let's see. Oh.
And see, like, at first I didn't...
So why didn't you just clean it?
This got washed. We washed it, and it doesn't come out. It's stained. And this one's very sentimental to me because a soldier gave it to me, and it has my birthday and my name engraved on it. So I couldn't throw this one away. The other blanket and the rug I threw away because I assumed that she would replace it. Because she said, yeah, my bad, my wrong. I had a, you know, we messed things up. I'll fix it. So I assumed she was going to fix it.
Okay. Is that
wine? Know? So, and there's a big scratch on my bed.
Let's see.
And I'm the only one at the ranch that buys my own furniture because that's how much of my own heart and passion I put into my job. And this furniture was very expensive. It's a $20,000 bedroom set that I had sent from back east. It's beautiful. So she...
All right, let's see.
This is where they put a scratch. This is the bed, and then here's the scratch. Someone fell off of it with a heel on or something.
Do you remember who this customer was?
Yes, I remember his name. He hasn't been back since, but.
All right, repaired scratch.
So I've had
right
the
there.
Furniture
and
repaired.
Hold on, Amy, and this is a scratch. So that's easy to touch up, right?
That, you know, Your Honor, that's what I thought when I had cleaned up the room. It appeared that I did a good job, and I didn't seem to see anything that was out of the ordinary, but she called me up and said that there were some things that were bothering her about the room as far as things that I had messed
well,
up.
Well, here's more.
All right, let's
okay.
see.
Okay, now something got set on this table that actually ate the paint away, some type of oil or lubricant that, so I hope they don't use it on a human body because it sure ate the paint off of this table.
Well, you could just ask Bunny about it. What did you use? Okay, lube or oil?
Oil. You look at the second page, you see
second
that.
Page. What is that?
That's where it just ate the paint away.
Right
something
there.
sat on that table and it ate the paint away.
Okay. All right. What happened that night?
Well, honestly, Your Honor, I was quite intoxicated. We did. it was of the amount of party to where drinks are included, and so we kind of went crazy and we got drunk. And
who's we?
Me and this gentleman.
How much did he pay that night?
You know, it was about 10 grand for one night, so.
And there must have been, I don't know how many bottles of wine, but it got everywhere.
So, 10 grand, how long?
It was just for an overnight. Just.
Oh, the whole night?
Yeah, it was just, you know, you come in late evening and spend the night and then wake up and leave.
What did you do with him? You had wine with him?
Yes, we had several bottles of wine.
Red wine.
And
there's no question.
No question.
Okay. And what was the oil on the dresser?
You know, I couldn't tell you. I only use the normal lubes and oils that I use every day. And
Amy, these are two different dressers.
Yes, you got something on the other dresser, too. Some kind of water.
Do you know what she's talking about?
Is it on the one that's in front of your bed
take
or
a
on
look
the
at
side?
This, show this to the defendant.
So somebody gave her a sticky note. It got wet.
It's really, it's hard to say because the way her room is positioned, it's very cozy. It's like a little dollhouse. And so it's just so easy to sit things everywhere.
Put a 300-pound guy in my bathtub instead of yours. Break my bed instead of yours.
How big was this guy?
He was heavy.
She knows how much I really love my bed.
She loves her bed.
I
know she loves her bed.
I have the amount that I got charged for
estimates?
The repair.
Thank you.
No, not an estimate. The actual repair
you
amount.
You did repair them.
Yes.
She is
she's on top
well
of things,
prepared. All right, what I have here is Able Restoration. Prep, repair, refurnish, color, blend, and match areas. One large dresser, one dresser vanity, one side bed rail. Total, $2,565. Was that to cover him for whatever he got that day, too?
I wasn't there that day. Because otherwise,
That's a lot of money.
I would have definitely negotiated for less.
$2,565 and $50 for the rug. What else do you want to say, Amy?
Well, I'm just sorry that it had to come to this, Bunny. You know, you're my very best friend at the ranch, and I don't want our friendship to get spoiled, and I want you to have good values. You know, just because we do what we do doesn't mean you can lie, cheat, or steal, or put people off, and you're going to be making a lot of money in your career, and you're going to have a lot of opportunities. People can sue you, so you just be careful, and you hold true to your word.
Let me ask you this. Is there competition? I mean, how does this happen? People stand up at the ranch? The
competition
women come
between
out.
Me and Amy or competition between everyone? There's competition
between
everybody.
There's healthy competition. We're a highly motivated sales team.
You got to give them credit. I mean, these are entrepreneurs. It is the oldest profession in the world. It goes without saying, you know? And I have to tell you that you're both very articulate. Very smart ladies, and, you know, as long as what you're doing is legal, as long as you report your income, you're not going to get in trouble, okay?
We make men feel good. We have men that come in that have just been, their hearts put through a blender, and when they leave our house, they feel like $1 million. So we're doing a real good service. For
social
people.
Work, huh?
Yes, sir. Ma'am.
All right, the issue for the court is whether the defendant, whether negligently or intentionally damaged the plaintiff's property. The plaintiff has made it clear, and the defendant agrees that she allowed the defendant to use her room during a time when the plaintiff was absent, and the court orders you to pay $2,615.
I should get punitive damages, too, Your Honor.
Why?
Because I'm on Watch Street buying a new truck. I watched her go to Lollapalooza, lots of concerts, get her hair done, get her nails done, get new clothes, and
You've
all this.
You've been
time.
With me the whole time.
So,
we do all of this together.
Yeah, and so therefore you think you should get punitive damages?
Yes, ma'am.
No. when you took her to these places, did you charge her?
No, we went together as friends.
Okay, who paid?
We pay for our own things.
So then why would you get punitive damages?
Because she's going to do all these fun things and buying new stuff, and I haven't get paid for none of mine.
You know what, Amy? It looks
year.
Like you bought all the stuff you need by the way you're shining in this courtroom. So honored. Thank you.